Hi everyone and welcome back to XGate Dental. I'm Emmanuel Kadosh and we are here to discuss new procedures in the field of dentistry. We will provide interesting new cases to exhibit how doctors use our products to solve complicated dental cases. Don't forget to subscribe and follow to stay up to date. So let's get started. Today we're going to be talking about and showing you that when you're using CAD CAM, sometimes you need to have good and accurate model. For example, if you want to make a PFM restoration, porcelain fused to metal, the technician that designs the porcelain needs to have a metal to be based on. You need to have good digital analogues and you need the analogues to fit correctly to the model that you print on. So from our experience, what we see in different companies is that you have a good digital analog, but every technician uses different printers, different materials, and you have some deviation between the analogs and the models themselves. So if one technician uses one company's analogs with other material printer, the analog can fit correctly, or it can be loose or even not fit at all, and then there's no solution to solve this problem. So right now we are going to show you a way on how we're solving this problem with our specific libraries. In this case, we see the upper jaw, temporary restoration. From PMMA, you can see problematic teeth on both sides. You know that it's temporary and that you can see the caries from the bridge. These teeth will need to be extracted. Now, if we fast forward, we take off the bridge and we extract the teeth. Now, in this moment, we need to have some implantation. We need to place implants. Some will go in their anterior region and some in the posterior. We place the implants, we make sutures, and we wait until we can choose what type of multi-units we want to use, and then we take impressions. Let's say we took impressions. Now is the problematic part. Now you need to have a working model to adjust the upper lip, the lower jaw, and connect all of the parts to this case. Now in zichronia, for example, if you're making a crown or two crowns or small bridges in many cases, you don't need a working model because if you have a monolithical zichronia, you have the working model in your computer. It's all digital. You don't need to have a working model because you don't need to put ceramics. You can just glaze it, color it a little bit, almost doesn't have any thickness. So you can finish the case without a working model. In cases when you do need to add ceramics, in cases when you have PFM, in cases when you need to check or when you need to move things or you need to visualize, you need to have a real life working model. And when you're using CAD CAM, it's a problem to have a working model because everything is digital. You need to take all of the digital information and make it real. You need to print the working model, and the working model is from plastic, so you need to have digital analogs that will be inserted to the working model. The digital analogs needs to fit well, and or else the bridge that you will design originally on the digital working model won't fit on the model, on the working model that you have in your hand. So in this case, we can see a scan. We can see a scan of the six upper implants. It's a case of like all on six. We can see the scan abutments, the impressions were taken on multi-unit level, and scan abutments on multi-unit level. And what we want to do now is we want to have a working model and to be able to make a PFM. In this case, the doctor wants to have a PFM in the end. This is the end result. In the end, you can see that we have a PFM made from two parts. We have the base with the gingiva and you have the screw channels in the base, as well as different crowns. Different porcelain fused to metal crowns that was based on the base. And it was all on a working model. For this type of work, you must have a good working model because you take out and put back in a lot of times. The base and the crown, so you'll play with it a lot. So your working model needs to be good and needs to be high quality. You can see here the doctor designed a working model from two parts. You have a gingiva that was printed separately and you have the base of the working model. In the base of the working model, it's made from hard plastic. Hard plastic can be printed a little bit different with different types of printers and different types of materials. So in this case, if you use some kind of printer or if you use different kinds of material, you can get different results depending on the material and depending on the shrinkage factor of the material because it's a big model. The shrinkage factor will be quite large in this case. You have a large height of the model. The model itself is very big, so now what you need to do is you need to calibrate the place of the analog according to the model, to the printer, and to the material that you're using. What we recommend is every time you change the printer or every time you change the material from one material to another, make a calibration. Now, how is this calibration done? Well, when you download our library, what you have is in the folder of the library, you'll have a space of scaling. Space of scaling is what we call different types of spacers around the nominal spacer. For example, the normal spacer we call 1.0. You can have a smaller spacer or a bigger space depending on on the nominal one that we chose. In addition to these spacers, you have a calibration jigs. What's a calibration jigs? Well, it's a block of four calibration that has different types of holes that can demonstrate different types of spacers. It looks something like this. You can see here what type of analogues you're using. If you're using analogues for internal hex implants, this jigs is what you need. You have five different holes with five different kinds of spacers, and you have the name of the spacer of the corresponding hole. So you print this jig, you take the analog that you have, and you just try to insert it to each one of these holes that it fits best. You just take the files from the spacer. You move them to the main library, the main folder of the library, and you'll use this spacer every time you change it from one material to another, or changing to different printer, or making a large change in the printing technique. You need to probably calibrate again to have the best result that you can get. In this way, you can print the gingiva, you can print the temporary model, you can print the model of the temporary bridge, and you can print the model itself. Everything will fit just as it's supposed to in the mouth. Because the spacer fits, the analog fits best in the model. And each time something doesn't fit, you have more and more deviance from the original positioning in the mouth. Every time you take impressions, you print something, you make a model of something, you lose the accuracy that you originally had. So this is why we try to maintain the most accurate, best results by calibrating every step of the way. In here, if you calibrate, you'll get a good fit between the analog and the model, and the bridge that you design will be made on the original models that you scan in the patient's mouth. You don't scan on the working model at all. It's not recommended at any time. You just print a small box. You don't need to change anything in the printer. You do everything in the library on ExoCAD. It's all available, you just switch the files, and you have everything for this printer with this material. Thank you everyone that joined in to learn some new and interesting information. Make sure to stay tuned for more, and of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow. Thank you, and see you next time.